Alright, welcome back guys, part 2. We started our initial attempt to Key West, Florida. Our nav runway 09 approach. Again, if you watch part one of the video, I did call out some quirks, but overall it's a very solid aircraft for what you're getting here and the price point, to be perfectly honest with you. No complaints in that regard. We are coming into Icarus. Icarus, the developer here, I think they have about 5 or 6 different products, 2 in the U.S., which is San Diego, and Key West. I'm using freeware, Mr. X San Diego, so I don't have the Icarus scenery for that, but I didn't find any solid freeware or default for Key West. I picked up Icarus, I think it was about $14, and it does come with the orthorol scenery around the airport, so it should be pretty nice coming in. It'll be my first time checking it out, so we'll see. Didn't mention, I think in part one, I heard or I've read that this newly updated version of the JAR does simulate icing. So the aircraft detects as well as simulates icing, so that's pretty cool. We're coming into Key West, Florida right now, so I don't think we'll encounter any Key West showing 77 degrees Fahrenheit, and east at 5 knots, temperature 3009. Got overcast at 5,000 feet and a few at 3,000 feet. So really no conditions for icing there that we should see us coming into a thunderstorm or something. In any event, the aircraft does detect and simulate icing. You would see it here, the indicator, and I did hear that you would see it on the wings of the aircraft as well. So we'll eventually do a flight in some cold weather, and we'll check it out. Fipes at 240. We got 15 Fipes and we're at 29, crossing 290 now. Yeah, I knew that was coming. Just that drag. 99 miles from the airport. I think this thing should have calculated the top of the descent a little bit earlier. So I'm going to go ahead and again, like I mentioned in one of my early videos, I am using the butt kicker game with 2. Really adds to immersion. I think you feel everything. So again, I just had the spoilers disarmed and you really feel the chair rumble in there. The more you increase spoilers and drag, up the butt kicker properly, you can really feel the difference. Pretty cool. You also feel the gear coming down in retraction, especially when those doors close, you really feel that thud. It's a really neat product. I picked it up about a year and a half ago now, and I don't sim without it. And it's really not terribly noisy or anything like that. I have it on the lowest setting, and that's decent enough, to be honest. Them as usual. No ATC on at the moment, so we're on Unicom. believe it. I really want to see this autopilot logic without me intervening too much. Worst case scenario, if we're too fast, we'll just take vectors and bleed off some speed and altitude and then turn back in. Not much traffic on Baptum right now, and no air traffic control, and not much traffic even coming into Key West, so we can play around with that if necessary. Handling the descent pretty well. We're through 10,000, so the knots are on the tags. Get our lights on. That's our airport there, 12 o'clock. We want to be at Chet. 3,100 feet at Chet's. plethora of scenery yet. Gotta break through these clouds. Again, active sky reporting 6,000 feet ceiling, so we should be breaking through this soon. 2, speed checks. About an 8 mile final. See that ortho scenery coming in. All the pilot really doing a good job. Take laps 3, gear down. requires a lot of thrust to get moving. Down in Key West. Very hard landing. Let me see what Project Fly recorded. -274. Although felt it was harder than that. And we'll be on the center line. Pitch 4, roll 0 degrees. So. Wasn't a terrible landing, and again, not really much runway to play with at Key West, so we had to get her down firm there. Call it quits for now. Thank you guys for watching, and again, my overall, I guess, thoughts about this aircraft is really solid. This new version seems, again, I never really flew the old version, but from the videos and comments that I've seen on the old version, this version seems leaps and bounds improved. So if you are interested in picking up the JAR A320, I highly recommend it, and again, with the BSS sound pack. In the event, thanks for watching, and we will see you guys next time.